I'm Aaron Plessinger, and I choose OGO.
I'm Levi Kitchen, and I choose OGO.
I'm Malcolm Stewart, and I choose OGO.
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 You know what? I'm not going to sugarcoat it, to be very transparent. It was a very rough day for me and for the team. We had quite a few issues throughout the day. Just out of everyone's control, we had to do, some bike issues early on in the day, and then after the during first moto as well. Like I said, no one just out of everyone's control, and they did a great job to get me back on the track for that second moto, and I rode pretty good. Then I got a rock stuck in the rear brake pedal and I fell over, and did the best I could, which was a 19-17 on the day. That's not very exciting. I love this place, and typically I race very well here. So to walk away with those results, I'm not very happy about that. But I'm still sitting 10th in points, and like I said, the team's doing a fantastic job. So we'll keep just plugging away.
That was great that you pointed out the 10th in points, because that was the follow-up. Hey, Freddie, it's awesome. I love seeing it happen. I love seeing the program that you have going on, and then just working class guys out there, 10th best in the pro class program. So how's that feel?
Yeah, no, for sure. I mean, we're pretty competitive, or we are competitive against all of these big dogs. You know, it's a lot of effort on everyone, and we're doing a good job. And like I said, the team, the Mad Parts, Kawasaki team's doing a good job. And we're just going to muscle through a weekend like this. We have those sometimes, and get ready for Red Bud. So I'm excited for next weekend.
Okay, hey, we know on that off weekend that the team came out to club and trained with you. How was that?
Yeah, no, it was very beneficial. They came down after High Point, and we did 2 days of testing, which was really, really good. Obviously, today didn't necessarily show, we're continuing to build those little building blocks and just get a little bit better each and every day. So that's really all we can do at this point. So just look ahead.
Thanks, Freddie.
Thank you.
Yeah, eventful. Welcome back to Outdoors. It definitely didn't go smooth today. Didn't go as smooth as I'd like, but I would much rather have a day like this now, when it necessarily doesn't mean anything points wise, than next year when I'm actually going to be starting the championship with this team. So for me, I've had a couple of weeks on the program. I definitely realized today that I was a bit off with the way that I set myself up. It's been tough. I haven't raced a 250 in outdoors in a long time. I've got knowledge and feel from a 450, kind of. So all the riding that I've been doing in the week, I've been kind of referencing that, but it's definitely the 250 class is just different. It's chaos. Qualifying, I was sixth or seventh in the first one, which I thought was fine. Although I felt like my lap should have been a bit better than that. So I was like, okay, right, I could have made a few adjustments here and there. But then my lap got taken away from me. So my second time wasn't great. And with all the B guys going fast in the first practice, I didn't get the best gate pick in the first moto. Not that it really mattered, because the second one I was 40th anyway. But first moto, the gate pick wasn't great. I messed the start up, just wrong RPM. And that's one of those where you can do as many practice starts at home, and it's fine alone, but when I'm around everyone, I just went the wrong RPM and span a little bit and fluffed it up. So that's that. Came around in the mid-pack carnage and then got T-boned and crashed, or I don't know, I hit someone, I don't even know what happened. Then my bike was broken, I had something rammed in my rear wheel and my pipe was broken. So first moto was done. I was like, great, welcome back to Outdoors for that one. And then and the second moto, obviously last gate pick, actually wasn't too bad on the start. I got my way inside the top 10, but that was about all I could do. I was not that comfy and not super happy with how I was feeling, but that's kind of to be expected. I guess we'll learn and figure it out for Red Bud.
Thanks, Max.
Cheers. It was good. Happy with the results. Didn't get off the gate very well, but rode really good. First time here since 2018 for me. didn't come up last week, so it was pretty gnarly out there. I was not really sure what to expect. I'm not the best sand guy at home, so really happy with how the day went overall.
Hey, you were sick for a little bit. Did you kick it over the break?
Yeah, it was tough, man. I haven't been sick like that in my life, where it just like lingers on. Was really struggling at Colorado. High point, I was feeling a little bit better, but not like all the way back. And then I would honestly say it was this Tuesday that like I did a bike ride and I did gym, and I was like, wow, like this is the first time I actually feel good in probably a month. So yeah, I think I'm pretty much back. I definitely have probably lost a little bit of that top end fitness a little bit. Just I took basically 2 weeks off riding other than the races, and yeah, kind of build back into it. But today was a good day. I mean, I pushed pretty hard all the way to the end of both motos.
Okay, as those motos are going on and you guys are always looking for smooth lines, how much do they change from lap to lap? And especially in some of those drop-offs, are you just kind of jumping into them blind?
Yeah, for sure, some of them. You can't really find smooth lines out there, that's for sure. Some spots you can, but it's one of those things like the safe way around is to go inside everywhere, like really inside, but it's not as fast. But like if you try to sweep out, it's faster. But like if the line's blown out, like it'll just go up the track and then you lose 2 or 3 seconds or you crash. So it's kind of like that like game of like how much do you want to push those kind of outsides. Honestly, it was pretty one line. Like I feel like everyone was kind of going the same places. Like I'll have to watch the race back and see like kind of where Haiden and some of those guys up front were going. But like I really, there was like 2 or 3 sections I felt like you could take other lines, and then everywhere else like it just, everything on the outside blew off the track, so you just had to go inside and just kind of rip the berm to the outside.
It was that, or you, if you took the outside, you went through a huge hole, like,
yeah, or like
off.
Or like if you took the outside, then like the inside berm, you had to go over it, and yeah, you would lug down, and then you'd be trying to build speed for the next straightaway. So I think the hardest thing out here like with this track is like if you do make a mistake and like you drop into a hole that you normally like wheelie over, like it ruins your rhythm, and it can be like hard to get that rhythm back. Like you might not get it back, honestly.
Thanks, Jordon.
Yep. Like slow start of the day. First session in qualify wasn't great. That put me into really bad gate pick for 26 gate pick, I think. But yeah, first moto crashing the first turn, which made it tough. P9, and second moto, okay start, kind of like, you know, chasing Vial, like I see him getting away from me, but when I saw like last 6 laps to go on the pit board, I kind of put a sprint lap together and caught him and made a pass, and last 3 lap was like really intense, but kind of like good confidence because moving forward because of like proving good fitness. Just have to ride, get a start like that, and then I think I can keep up with these guys. So yeah, it makes me want to race next weekend.
And always good to get a win. Like always, oh, nice to have a win.
Oh, for sure. If a win or second, it's a big difference, you know. To win it, you have to kind of like take charge. So it was a good one.
Thanks, Joe.
Thank you.
Yeah, today was awesome. First moto, I made a statement with a 16-second win. That was cool. And then second moto, was leading again and made a mistake. I tried to switch up my line because I heard Tom catch me in that back section right there. So went to the outside and just tucked the front. Stupid mistake. And good thing I have the fitness and stuff because I know I was like, get back up and it's time to charge. And we charged all the way back up to Tom and Joe, and Joe got around Tom, and I didn't know that I had the overall right there. So I was just balls to the walls trying to get around Tom, and Tom ended up going down too because he had to pass Joe. So it was a big pressure scenario. And yeah.
Okay, I've been talking about this for a couple weeks. Today is the biggest example of it. Bro, what's it like to know how excited you get to watch people, like have people watch you ride? Like when you did that move on Levi at the start today, this entire hill freaked out. And yeah, like that's every lap, every moto. Like how does that feel?
Yeah, 100%. I think it's a lot. I mean, these fans, they just want to, you know, you have the fans that don't like you and the fans that do like you. And I think it's kind of a, they want to see what I do every weekend. So when I pull stuff out like that, where I'm making a pass on the first lap and nearly dying, almost killing myself, the fans go crazy. And yeah, I mean, that was cool. So the fans have been great, though. I mean, you're going around the track, and anytime you get into a battle, you just hear the roars of the crowd down the straightaways, and it's motivating, so it's cool.
It's got to be a cool feeling.
Yeah, 100%.
Thanks, Haiden.
Yep.